First up, we have Slava Kim, who is a core developer at Meteor.
Hi, my name is Slava. I'm a core developer in Meteor. And today, I'm going to talk about Meteor Redis support, experimental Redis support. So if you come to DevShops often, you probably have caught this talk. It's a talk by Justin Santababa on DevShop May 2014. And he talked about experiments with Redis. And since then, we collaborated with Justin, and we shipped experimental Redis support for Meteor. Not experiments now, just support. And it is on the Atmosphere. And you can download it now, and you can use it in your projects and help us find all the bugs. So a little bit about Redis, if you don't know what it is an in-memory key-value data storage with on-disk persistence. So it's known to be quite fast, faster than it might replace MongoDB in your stack for your application. And it is known for having a lot of different data structures, such as strings, hashes, sets, audit sets, list, etc. So when Justin presented his talk, he had an idea to replace all Meteor collections with Meteor Redis collections. What that would do, it would preserve the same API of MongoDB, but use Redis as backend store. So it would be really easy to swap the database. You don't need to port any code, and you will still use the same Mongo queries. The problem was it's quite hard to translate all the Mongo queries to a Redis API, and you lose all the speed that Redis gives you. Another approach we went with was just a direct Redis support, has the same API as raw Redis, and create mini Redis as a client cache. And we can see that it's a clear performance win because you don't need to keep extra cache or anything like this. You don't need to translate every query. So what is mini Redis? There are two packages that we released. First one is mini Redis. The second one is Redis live data. Mini Redis is an in-memory data structure similar to mini Mongo. You use it as a browser cache for your application to quickly access it and have latency compensation. Also, we have Redis live data, and that's like the heavy package that implements PubSub, security rules, deals with pushing data to the clients, and so on. And particularly, it implements the latency compensation by simulating actions on the browser and then like calling the RPC on the server. So here's a very bad diagram, how it works. We have Blaze and each block helper. That's what you use in your templates. Blaze usually uses a cursor for mini Mongo, but now it also can use your mini Redis cursor. And it calls observed changes on that cursor. And mini Redis is connected with DDP over the WebSocket, and you implement PubSub logic in your app code. And publications are also implemented by observed changes, but now on the server side. And that's where it works. Like, it works in Redis live data on the server part. Also, some pieces of your application code can use observed changes. And it all comes from Redis key space notifications. So the common usage patterns for Redis, usually you have a bunch of keys. And since everything is flat key value store, you kind of structure your model inside keys. For example, you can have a key called users, double colon, ID of the user, double colon, and then a field name. And then the value of this key value pair would be the actual value, as it would be in a Mongo document, for example. So it's very common to have a pattern like this. So we created this concept of mini Redis cursors and the Redis cursors. Those represent a particular subset of data. And they work on pattern matching. You can say, give me everything that corresponds to user number one, and it will give you basically the representation of that data subset. And you can fetch it or start observing that if this data changes. So what works? We implemented strings and hashes. And as far as we understand, that's the most common use case for data that you push to your client. Every other data structure you usually use only on the server. For example, you wouldn't like fetch a giant set to your client. You just use it server-side to quickly look up something. And same goes with other data structures. So we implemented only strings and hashes so far, and it seems to be sufficient. We implemented latency compensation, meaning that your app is still responsive, and you can like have any operation happening on the data store like literally in milliseconds, and then it will go to the server and actually do the query. So we also implemented the each support for Blaze and allow denial rules, pops up, auto publish, insecure, everything you would expect. What doesn't work? As I said, like you probably don't want to push giant data sets to the client anyway, so we didn't even bother implementing different data structures and big hashes. Like every time some hash changes, it will send the whole hash to the client without diffing. And we didn't implement accounts because accounts is very Mongo specific at this point. So if you want to have an advanced account system with password recovery, emails, and OAuth support, you would need to use Mongo probably. But all operations on Redis still would be fast. And it is on Atmosphere, it is on GitHub. We host it under Meteor namespace. If you want to contribute, you can submit a pull request with tests or maybe like even features implemented, but please talk to us before you do it, so you don't waste time. And we also will welcome any community support as bug reports or fixes to documentation. We have a pretty good documentation so far, I think. Like we describe the whole process, how do you set up your Redis server and connect to it. And you can use, I think, any popular Redis hosted Redis provider, like anyone who provides you key space notifications, that would be good enough. So on that, I want to show the Atmosphere page. It has 9 downloads, very exciting. And a test app that we built, which is also open source, is called Redis Example. It is a clone of Yo, which is a popular app recently. The domain is meteoyo.meteor.com. You can log in with any name because it doesn't have accounts, and you can yo people like this, and I can yo myself. And I can see that one of my fans yoed me. That's cool. Thank you. Thanks. No, please don't yo me. And obviously, yeah, it's like mobile optimized. I can swipe left and right and delete people. So I just deleted myself. So yeah, that's a good starting point to see how you would use Redis. And thank you.
Thank you, Slava. We have time for one or two questions. Yes.
So the question was, can we use both Redis and Mongo in the same application? The answer is yes. That was the whole point. Like, if you want, you probably want to use something that looks more like a database. Redis is more like key-value store. But for use cases, for example, when you have a very active online game where you need a lot of communication back and forth, Redis might be more performant. So it makes sense to have your account system and, let's say, I don't know, some global leaderboard across past 3 years in MongoDB and have some securely like temporary like a game state in Redis. So that was yes, like that was the primary use case. All right. Any other questions?
Thank you so much, Slava.
Oh, okay. Thank you.